Thank you, Lucy.
Good to see you.
Okay, good. So, morning, everyone.
Thank you, the Honourable Minister for Health and Medical Services, Your Excellency the Australian High Commissioner, the Honourable Assistant Ministers, distinguished guests, and especially the representatives of community health workers throughout Fiji. Ladies and gentlemen, Bula Vinaka, and a very good morning to you all. Your Excellencies, with the general standard of health in Fiji still far from satisfactory, the role of community health workers has never been more important. So I'm delighted to join you this morning for the signing of a Memorandum of Understanding to revitalize our community health program and take it to another level. This agreement between the Ministry of Tokay Affairs and the Ministry of Health and Medical Services is designed to strengthen the community worker health program that began, I understand, 38 years ago in 1978. It is a partnership with the Australian government through its Fiji Health Sector Support Program. So I want to begin by acknowledging support and ask Excellency, the Australian High Commissioner, to pass on our gratitude to her government and the Australian people. Thank you, Your Excellency. Ladies and gentlemen, Your Excellency, this program is designed to improve the effectiveness of our community health workers and their efforts to raise health standards at the grassroots in the hundreds of individual communities scattered throughout Fiji. Community health workers are community-based volunteers who act as the first point of contact between ordinary Fijians and the Ministry of Health and Medical Services. The best of them are practical, sensible, and accessible people with a genuine sense of caring for the well-being of the communities and the health needs of the people, from the very young to the very old. They not only enable ordinary Fijians to access health services quickly and efficiently in times of need and to navigate the system, but they are also important health coaches, encouraging all members of the community to pursue healthy lifestyles, and take care of themselves in a holistic way. Whether it is to eat better, exercise more, give up smoking, or curb their consumption of alcohol or yangona. In a typical community, a health worker might encourage a mother to have her children immunized or give her advice on the best food to feed a baby. It might be to remind an elderly person to take their blood pressure, medication, or work with someone with diabetes to stabilize their condition with a better diet. And of course, all community workers have a special responsibility towards pregnant mothers in our communities, to remind them of their appointments with a nurse or doctor, assist them and their families to prepare for the birth of their child, and of course, to provide education on breastfeeding. So ladies and gentlemen, Your Excellency, our community health workers are vital members of Fijian society, pillars of our communities with a special understanding of nature, of those communities and the needs of our people. But unfortunately, we have found that they don't always enjoy the support of those communities they deserve and that they need to make them more effective. Report 5 years ago, I understand, by the Ministry of Health, funded by the Australian government, revealed that out of the 606 community health workers interviewed, 85% said they had no support from the communities at all. And this was leading to a huge turnover of community health workers as they left the system to pursue more satisfying roles in which they felt more valued and effective. This is clearly not good enough if we are to deal effectively with the health challenges we face, and especially the alarmingly high incidence of non-communicable diseases in Fiji. We have one of the highest rates of NCDs in the world. Preventable diseases such as heart disease, hypertension, and diabetes. A study 3 years ago showed that a staggering 80% of the premature deaths of Itauke between the ages of 40 to 45 were due to NCDs. I repeat, these deaths are preventable. They needn't happen at all. And it is vital that we make the battle against NCDs an important national priority. Part of this means educating our people that a change of lifestyle can change and save lives, that eating less fatty food and more fresh vegetables and fish, not drinking as much kava or alcohol, and walking rather than taking the bus can make a huge difference to a person's lifespan and general well-being. We must also step up our effort to emphasize that prevention rather than cure is the best way to relieve the huge burden that NCDs are having on our health budgets and the system as a whole. The burden on our hospitals and health clinics caused by diseases that can be prevented must be lifted. And it is the responsibility of every Fijian to play their part in this effort. Ladies and gentlemen, that is why this program of strengthening the community health worker system is so important. And not just in the battle against NCDs, but by using these workers more effectively to educate our people about a range of health challenges, many of them also preventable. Unfortunately, here too, the Itauke are especially vulnerable. Almost 60% of all maternal deaths and 60% of pregnancy-related deaths are among Itauke women. There is also a higher incidence among the Itauke of typhoid, dengue fever, and other diseases. And malnutrition in children under 5 years of age is also higher than among other Fijians. We must make more of an effort as a nation to confront this crisis. We must build a better bridge between our community health workers and the people who desperately need their services. They need to be engaged at a much better level. And I'm delighted to see a concerted effort being undertaken in this report to embrace a range of measures to turn the situation around. They include more funding, better training, better standards of governance, more comprehensive community participation through village health committees, more clearly defined roles for our health workers, more clearly defined roles for the two ministries involved in this program, stronger links between the health system and provincial councils, and better supervision and monitoring of the program to ensure more effective outcomes. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to close by warmly thanking the community health workers who are present here today, representing, I understand, more than 1,500 others across Fiji. I salute you all for your dedication to improving health outcomes for the Fijian people. You are already making a difference, and with better support, I know you'll be able to make much more of a difference. But that depends not only on providing you with better tools to do your job, but strengthening your links with your communities. So I also want to close by making this appeal to the Fijian people as a whole. Seek out your community health workers. Engage with them. Tap into their wisdom and knowledge. Treat them as valued members of your community, as friends, because they are there to help you. And they are a vital link to better health outcomes for every Fijian, and especially in rural and isolated communities. To everyone who has been involved in this program, Vinakabu Alebu, on behalf of every Fijian. And I have great pleasure on behalf of the nation wishing this program every success. Vinavagulevu, God bless you all.
Thank you very much. The Honorable Prime Minister and Minister for Ethiopia Affairs. Her Excellency, the Australian High Commissioner. Permanent Secretary of Ministry of Health and Medical Services and Permanent Secretary for Ministry of Ethiopia Affairs. Representatives of government, non-government organizations and civil society. Our special community health workers and community leaders. Mr. Bulavnak, and a very good morning to you all. Please excuse my voice. As the MC stated, as I woke up this morning, though I had a smile on my face, I had a little bit of fear in my heart as well. So before getting out of bed, I shot a quick prayer and I said, please God, help us get over these adverse weather conditions that we are currently experiencing for the betterment of all Fijians. Ladies and gentlemen, this morning it also gives me great pleasure to extend to you a very warm welcome on behalf of the Ministry of Health and Medical Services and to say how grateful we are for the partnership with the Ministry of Ethiopia Affairs and of course for the presence of our Honourable Prime Minister here this morning to seal this collaboration and witness the signing of this Memorandum of Understanding for our community health workers. I must also again acknowledge our hardworking and diligent community health workers, largely, I believe, and exclusively a strong group of women who work within our communities. And of course, for them being finally recognized and rewarded through this Memorandum of Understanding for the years of service, as mentioned, 38 long years of service. Many are here with their community leaders to celebrate this auspicious occasion, and I welcome you all once again. You offer a wonderful example of delivering services for the community, and you have done so much with compassion and diligence to your communities for many, many years without any rewards or any recognition. We salute you all community health workers for this country, and can I invite the audience present here today to put their hands together for our wonderful community health workers. Thank you very much. Please also convey our gratitude to your families for the support and the patience over the many, many years. Ladies and gentlemen, the Community Health Workers Program was established almost 40 years ago, and today marks the first formal agreement which recognizes the efforts of our health workers and the many, many contributions to the health and well-being of our many communities. The agreement reflects active dialogue and mutual understanding between the government ministries. It also signals our appreciation for the work of our community health workers. The agreement will greatly enhance their work and effectiveness, and it will ultimately contribute to the well-being of all our communities and fellow Fijians. This is the first of many collaborations which will be undertaken between ministries to enhance the delivery of health services throughout Fiji. We know that health outcomes are determined as much, if not more, by factors outside the health system than they are by the services delivered in hospitals and health centers. That is why, as a Minister for Health and Medical Service, I need to reach out to my colleagues in other ministries to gain their support for such initiatives, such agreements that help to build health into every aspect of our lives. The signing of this Memorandum of Understanding will not only foster closer collaborations with the Ministry of Ethiopia Affairs, but it will also enhance our healthcare delivery to communities, community members throughout Fiji. Our community health workers are a major link between our public health facilities and the communities they serve. The Ministry of Health and Medical Services is already in the process of exploring and negotiating with other ministries and stakeholders in organizing smaller, similar support and assistance for communities in informal settlements and sectors as well. It is also imperative in light of the chronic diseases, in emerging diseases, that our community health workers continue to be effective in the delivery of health service and remain the key link between communities and the health system. As mentioned, the increase in NCDs, such as diabetes and hypertension, combined with the high prevalence of communicable diseases, such as TB and HIV, illustrates the need for prevention and early intervention. The Ministry of Health and Medical Services seeks to involve communities and their leaders in these efforts. The Honourable Prime Minister commented earlier at the beginning of the Community Health Worker Programme in 1978 as a response to the Alma Ata Declaration that has its main focus on enhancing primary health care. Since then, through the dedication and perseverance of these men and women, many lives have been saved and major disabilities averted through selfless acts such as accompanying sick people to hospitals, encouraging young pregnant women to book early for appointments, and ensuring that they stick to their appointments, applying basic first aid for injuries and accidents before people are taken to hospitals, etc. There is scientific evidence that confirms the effectiveness of community health workers' programs in promoting immunization, reducing mobility and mortality in children, promoting breastfeeding, and improving TB treatment outcomes. More importantly, community health worker programs are also found to be cost-effective in expanding services to the undeserved, including hard-to-reach parts of our country, such as the remote hills and distant islands. The Ministry of Health and Medical Services values the contribution of all our community health workers, which is reflected in today's theme for community health workers, the link to healthier communities. The vision of the Ministry of Health and Medical Services is a healthy population. We aim to achieve this by empowering people to take ownership of their health and assisting people to achieve their health potential by providing quality preventative, curative, and rehabilitative services through our caring, sustainable healthcare system. Community healthcare workers contribute a great deal in helping us reach our vision. That is why we will continue to support and assist them in their vital work. The Ministry of Health and Medical Services is also committed to strengthening the Community Health Worker Program through its Community Health Worker Policy that was launched in 2015. We will soon establish a National Community Health Worker Steering Committee under this policy to oversee the support and build capacity of our community health workers in the service delivery. At this point in time, I'd like to acknowledge the generous support and assistance of the Australian Government through its Fiji Health Sector Support Program. Through that support, a number of training manuals were developed for community health workers. They cover core competencies, promoting safe motherhood in communities, promoting child health in communities, promoting wellness, the antenatal care flip chart toolkit, and emergency response basic first aid. Your Excellency, please, if we can show appreciation to the Australian Government for its continued support, ladies and gentlemen. Based on that, the Ministry of Health Services has continued that work and has used the same templates to develop modules on water sanitation, hygiene, and TB. We firm plans to develop more manuals on specific health topics to ensure that our community health workers have the necessary broad range of skills and knowledge needed by the communities. Australia has also significantly contributed to the training of our community health workers. As mentioned, we have currently almost 1,600 community health workers, of which Fiji Health Sector Support Program trained more than 1,004 of them on core competencies, more than 1,100 on safe motherhood, 1,000 on child health, and almost 900 on wellness. I truly believe that our partnership with the Australian Government and others yet to come will bring about total changes within our communities that will not only enhance our healthcare delivery, but also encourage the ownership of health among individuals. The Prime Minister mentioned that every individual, every Fijian has a part to play when it comes to the health of individuals and their communities. At this point, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank both the ministries for their efforts and understanding and for embracing the concept of community health workers as a valuable link to healthy communities and thus a healthy population. May we continue to work together for the health and well-being of our people and achieve the vision of a healthy population. With these words, I wish you all a very, very Merry Christmas and a very, very prosperous New Year. Thank you.
To commemorate this important occasion, we also have a kit for this.
Okay.
Big round of applause for you.